Hi. So by now, if you're here, you've probably watched some videos about variables and some videos about conditional statements. And in this video, we are going to somehow combine those two in an interesting new way, and we're going to look at what it means to have a variable of type Boolean, right? What is a variable? A variable is a type, like an integer. It is a name, like we might make up the name X, and we might give it an initial value. So this is a totally reasonable variable, the integer x that you can't exactly see because I wrote it too high, but you can imagine, x equals 100. Right? This is crazy, I'm totally out of sync here, but let's make a variable now that has a type Boolean. Boolean going equals false. This is the type of the variable. It is not a number, it is not a string, it is not other types of variables that you may or may not have learned about. It is a Boolean. That means it only has two possible values, true or false. You could use an integer in many ways and have the integer be either 0 for false or 1 for true, but there are many other numbers that piece of data could be. In this case, the piece of data can only be false or true. And if you remember, a conditional statement is an expression if some expression evaluates to true, execute some code. Guess what? A Boolean variable evaluates to true or false, right? This Boolean going is false. So if going, that means we're not gonna execute this code because going is false. But if I change its value to true, then this code will become executed. So let's look at a way that we might use this in an example. Here is a very simple example. It has a circle moving across the screen. Size, background, an ellipse drawn at x, x equals x plus 2. What if I don't want this circle to start until I click the mouse? Well, you might think I would do something like, if mouse pressed and run this, and now the circle's not moving. If I click the mouse, it's moving. If I let go of the mouse, it stopped. But what if I want just the event of clicking the mouse to trigger the circle to move from now and forever going forward? So to do that, what if I made up my own variable, like going? And we say Boolean going equals false. I'm going to run this code. It's not moving. Now, if I change the value of going to true, it's moving because going is true. So this code is being executed. So now all I need to do is change the value of going from false to true the moment that I want the circle to start moving when I click the mouse. So in this case, right here, let's start with going as false. And then when in mouse pressed, this is an event that's triggered as soon as the user clicks the mouse. Let's set going equal to true. And it bothers me that you can't see all of the code here, so I'm just gonna make this fit here. Now we can see, okay, going is false. So when we run it, it's not moving. It's not moving because going is false. But now when I click the mouse, going becomes true, and it moves. I'm going to stop it. Click the mouse. Oh, no matter what, whenever I click the mouse now, going is true. What if I want going to become false? Here's a neat little trick. OK. We have time for this. I think we have time. You have time for this. I have somewhere I have to be. But I'm making this video anyway. Okay, so in mouse pressed, we are saying going equals true. But what if I want going to only become true if it wasn't true? And if going was already true, I want going to now be false. In other words, I want to say if going, then going equals false, right? If going is true, set going equal to false. Otherwise, set going equal to true. So if going is true, set it equal to false. Otherwise, if it was false, set it equal to true. Let's go implement that. Okay, so I'm down here, and I'm going to implement this. If going, and by the way, I could have written it like this. If going equals true, if going is equal to true. But that's really long-winded. Going is just true or false, and a Boolean expression evaluates to true or false. So I can really just say, instead of if going is equal to true, I can just say if going. By the way, if going equals false is the same as saying if not going. That exclamation point is not, if not going. My font should probably be a little bigger here, but hopefully you can read this. Okay, so remember, if going, if it's going, then going should be false. Otherwise, let's say going is true. Let's run this now, right? So going is false right now. So when I click the mouse, is going true? It's not. So otherwise, set going to true. Now if I click the mouse again, going is true. Going was set to false. Oh, what a magical thing that just happened. Ready? Okay, start, stop, start, stop. Oh, it's going to leave the screen. Okay, but if maybe you thought this was all. There's one more piece of this. This, though fine and good and perfectly reasonable, is rather long-winded, right? We as programmers, sometimes our whole life is just about trying to make things shorter, although that's not really any point to that. You might as well just make things long. It's good for things to be clear, readable. But anyway, if we want to make that shorter, let's examine this statement. Going equals not going. This seems like it must be some sort of illegal code that you couldn't possibly write, and it's self-referential and circular in some way that's not going to work. But in fact, this is exactly what we want in this particular case. Let's think about this again. Let's say x equals y plus z. If we have a statement like this, remember, we evaluate this side of the equation and store the result over here. So this, we're going to do the same thing here. We're going to evaluate this side of the equation and store the result here. It's kind of like how we, when you say x equals x plus 1, this seemed a little strange. It equals itself plus 1, but it's no big deal. If it were 5, 5 plus 1 is 6, so now x equals 6. This is an operation that increments x over and over again. 5 becomes 6, becomes 7. Talking way too fast in this video. But here, let's say going is true. What is not true? Not true is false. Let's say going is false. What is not false? True. So going equals itself, not itself, just takes the value of going, is if it's true, and turns it into false, if it's false, and turns it into true. This might give you a little bit of a headache, but I think as you start to think about it and write it down and think about it again, it will start to make more and more sense. So let's go back over here and let's look at what we can write here now. Going equals not going. Going is currently false, so as soon as I click the mouse, going is going to equal not false, which is true. And then I click the mouse again, going is going to equal not true, which is false. So this is just a little bit of an inkling of what it means to use a variable with a type of Boolean. It's just a little bit of a helper. We can store, it's kind of like we can store the value of a switch in our program. We can always know, is that switch on or is that switch off? And at any point, we could act upon that. If the switch is on, do this code. If it's off, do this other code. And we can also change the value of that switch by turning it on, setting it to true, or turning it off, setting it to false. Usually at the end of these videos, I think I usually give some sort of exercise. I can't think of one right now. But maybe what you might do is go and find some program that you wrote and see where you might store a value of true or false and act upon that. That could be something that you could do. I'll think of something better later, but we put it in the notes. Okay, I'm gonna stop this video and you're gonna enjoy the rest of your day. I'm over here and I'm going now. My going is true. Okay, bye.